science department. This is our second time at the office conference, and I choose this title, an update on the green migration, because I want to explain the activities that we done in the last 12 months. And LibreUmbria is a regional project that wants to adopt the LibreOffice suite in all the authorities in Umbria region. This is our logo, and is inspired to the office of logo of LibreOffice, and this is our little version. So with this project we want the documents free, open and shared. The members of LibreUmbria are the principal authorities of the region. The project is financed by Umbria region, and it has the supervision of the CCOS, that is competence center only on the open source into the Umbria region. It was born with a regional law in 2006, and the other supervision is from Consortium SIR Umbria, that is another authorities into Umbria region, that was born with another regional law. And Consortium SIR is the authority of the local government for the regional information system. This project is designed by one of the total of two local health authority in the region. Is signed by the two provinces of Umbria and from two municipalities of in the region. And in the project LibreUmbria there is another authorities that works only with public administration, that it is called LibreUmbria, and this is a school of public administration. So all the users that works in public administration are trained into this place from these authorities. And this is an important slide for me, because I live in Umbria region since 2000, and I think that Umbria region is beautiful, and our region is called the green heart of Italy, and it is green for natural beauties. In this slide there is the main place of Perugia. There is an important panorama during the spring season, and this is Assisi with the main church. So I think that our region is green for natural beauties that we have in our region, for the LibreUmbria migration, and the green like LibreOffice. And there is another point in this list, because our presentation, our project is done with internal resources. So the users from authorities are the trainers for the other users in other authorities. So in this way we can save a lot of money for the training phase, and we want to invest this money in other activities. For example, in some customization parts for LibreOffice or other components that can help the users in LibreUmbria conference, and I think that is very important to keep some project timeline. The project LibreUmbria was born on June 2012, and during this month there was the first meeting. And from October there was the phase of analysis. So we had a complete phase on the documents present in the office for check the compatibility of the documents. And an important phase for the test of the office in all the machines. And from October to December there was the first migration from regional council, but the regional council was an easy migration because they migrated from open office to the office. So the migration it was easy. But the real authorities migration is province of Perugia. That from March to December of the last year, the province migrated 1,200 BC. So, this is our authority for pilot phase. And this is an important authority. And we done everything. Tests on all the machine, on the documents, on the components, and customization of home, customization of XU file for save default file and other customization. And from October of the last year, Perugia Local Health Authority migrated the 600 PC on a total of 3,000. And the other two important parts of the LibreUmbria, I think that is Libre Campus and LibreUmbria at Scuola, at school. And in the next slide I show the two activities. And from May to September of this year, the municipality of Todi migrated with 70 BC. In August was born in Italia, and next presentation by Sonia, she will explain the Libre Italia. And in September will be the municipality of Terni with 50 BC. So at the moment on September we have 2,000 more or less PC on a total of 5,000. So the goal of the project are simple, maybe are simple for us and are simple for the people that works on the community, on the open source system. So we want to share highlights and the best practice with the methodology, but not only in the public administration, not only in the authorities, but in every part of our community. So in the school, in the small and medium enterprise, and with the final users, that the final users are the real user that every day uses the suite. So the last point is the growth of LibreOffice community. Not only LibreOffice community, Italian LibreOffice community, but the international LibreOffice community with some new authority that wants to enter in our project in the two parts, the activities. activities that we done in the last month are Libre Campus and LibreUmbria School. The problem is always maybe the training, because the users for us is at the center of the project. So the users must receive the training, and with a large number of users it's very difficult to train everyone. So we made a beta learning platform we called Libre Campus, and this platform is 100% open source. It is based on Moodle plus WordPress, and Moodle is used to learn things, so for the learning phase, and the WordPress for the blog break, for the blog part. So we share tips, we share documentation, we share news. We have a page with FAQ, and in this learning beta platform, with this platform, we want to train a large number of users, save money, share tips and documentation, create focusing courses, and create a community. All the material, not only the material of Libre Campus, but only all the material right during the project is released under our blog in a Creative Commons license, because we think that is important to share our experience, our slide, our program, our tips, because in this way the community can grow. And these are two simple images. This is a list of courses. We choose to make courses, not big courses, but courses for action. So I can create GAP documents. So this way there are little parts, and we made these parts with the SCORM object, so we can use and share the object with other communities, or with other people who want to create an alien platform. And the other part of the project is LibreUmbria at school. This is an important phase of our winter, because for the first time trainers from the authority became the trainers for parents and educators. We made three different courses on six sessions, and the courses on were on LibreOffice, Ubuntu, and Gloss. So this is important because we received a lot of good feedback from educators and parents, and from September will be a replication of and the highlight was on join up, that is an important European summit. This is the last part. Libre Italia is the first Italian community, and was born on the August of this year, and a large part of the founder of Libre Italia are members of the founder of the LibreUmbria. So we have the developers, trainers, ordinary users, and ICT professionals. These are the contacts of the LibreUmbria. The blog at the moment is only in Italian, but I hope for the next month we want to translate the documentation. But sometimes it's difficult not for the for the translation, but we have 5-6 people that, and we work every day on a lot of projects and parts of it. And that's all. Thank you.
The training was done in the schools, but after the school hours?
The trainers in the school, or the trainers for the athletes?
In the schools.
In the schools, during the afternoon, on from 3 p.m. to 6.
So after school hours in Italy.
Okay.
Did you
get a lot of people, a lot of parents? Sorry. Did you get a lot of people who came up to the meeting?
Se avevo comunque gente che ha partecipato.
50 teachers. 50 teachers and about 100 parents.
For three different sessions.
For public administrations. Yes, this is true.
Also in Italy.
This is true, also in Italy it happens, but not to the point to deploy a large number of Windows 8 machines.
Did you keep on the same PC the Office suite as before, for example, Microsoft, or you replace the old suite with the new one?
In the first period, we had the two suites, Office and LibreOffice, but only on the 10, 20 PC for testing. And from the first part of training, when the user received the first part, the first phase of training, during the next weeks, the developer of the technicians of the authorities replace the version the. The old version of Microsoft Office with a new customized version of the LibreOffice, and this is our decision because if a user has two different Office suite, maybe sometimes he wants to use always Office, and this is a migration, and it is an innovation because some function on or the ordinary work is different if you make with Office of the LibreOffice. Some operations are different.